First of all, this show is amazing. It starts off right off, right with a bang, like literally.
Yes.
I already can't wait for season two, but talk to me a little bit about your characters as we talk about the Hunters.
Sure. Okay, great. I play Millie Morris. She's an FBI agent. She's one of the first black women to work for the FBI in 1977. She's a trailblazer. She's smart. She's hungry. She's resilient. She does not give up. And she's on the hunt for people like this.
And by the way, you're terrifying on the show. Not so much real life. You seem like a really nice guy.
Thank you.
You are terrifying. But talk to me about your character, Travis.
Yes, well, the complete opposite to Millie as a character. Travis is the height of narcissism and psychopathy. He is only interested in his own ends, and he just wants to exert as much chaos and power over the world around him.
Now, there's a lot that I found very surprising about this show. First of all, the setting's 1977. This was a pivotal point in American culture.
Yep.
So can you talk to me about how that kind of backdrop really adds to this show? And about the Nazi hunting that's kind of happening?
Sure. About how the backdrop of 1977 adds to the show. I will say this. When I was putting my research together for Millie and, like, you know, looking at, like, what's happening in the news during this time and, you know, how the Bureau was formed and all this kind of stuff, one of the things I found fascinating is that this is, like, when serial killers were,
right?
Being created, coming to prominence?
Yeah,
I don't know.
Blowing up because of the media. It was taking a much more heavily.
I found that such a fascinating connection, especially, you know, of course, looking at it from like, you know, like the, you know, lawful nature and just trying to put, you know, figure out this case.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's super interesting because it was at the point where people could hear about connections between murders and therefore people would like start trying to emulate murders as well. It's sort of the start of the age of information, I suppose. Mm-hmm. And yeah, just how that influences society is very
That might be a tangent, but that was something that I found really fascinating.
Oh, no, yeah, completely.
So about Travis specifically, when you're reading through the scripts and you, because he does a lot of uncomfortable stuff to a lot of people, was there anything...
Uncomfortable
that,
stuff?
Definitely uncomfortable stuff. Is there anything that you got to was like, wow, this is a little much?
Honestly, I feel bad saying it, but no.
All right.
Like, I relished everything in the script because he's so different from me, so far away from me. I never get to do this stuff. This is it's been a pleasure as an actor to be able to play something so far away from me and to really try and delve into it. So yeah, just being able to exert as much violence as possible was very interesting for me.
Now, with your character's investigative work with the FBI, how does that differ from what the Hunters are doing and what they're kind of investigating as well? Because it all feels like it's heading towards a crescendo.
Quite insightful.
Yes.
I mean, you know, I think the big difference is that she's approaching it from a very, what she thinks is a very lawful process, and our Hunters, as a band of vigilantes, that's not their approach at all.